Hello guys, welcome to ITS, Information Technology Skills. So for today's video, start po nating pag-aralan kung ano ang variables and data types in C#. Okay, so let's start. Variables refers to a memory address where values are stored. When variables is created, space in the memory is also created, which is used for storing temporary data. So, ibig sabihin ng variables, guys, dun po ini-store yung mga values. Okay? So, gagawa siya ng memory address para dun mo ma-store yung isang value. For example, gusto mo i-store yung mga names ng classmate mo. So, gagamit ka ng variables para ma-store mo siya. So, next, how to declare a variable. Okay, so we have two ways on declaring a variable. First, we have data type, variable name equals value, and semicolon. Yung data type, guys, madi-discuss din dito sa video na to. So, tapusin nyo dun hanggang sa dulo. Then, next, we have the variable name or the var name. Yung variable name, guys, any name na maisip nyo, as long as it is unique. And of course, the value, ito po yung mga value na gusto mong ilagay dun sa variable name. Pero yung value po natin, guys, nakadepende kung ano yung ina-accept lang ni variable name. Kasi meron tayo dong data type. Okay, so itong declaration na to, or this syntax, ito yung initialization. So bakit siya tinawag na initialization? Kasi meron tayong initial value. May ilalagay ka na value ng variable. The next, meron tayong data type, variable name, and semicolon agad. Ito naman po yung tinatawag nating declaration. Bakit declaration siya? Kasi sinasabi mo lang na kailangan mo tong variable na to dun sa program mo. Mamaya malalagyan siya ng value. Okay? So yung initialization may value, yung declaration wala pa siyang value. Example, so we have here a string my name equals ITS semicolon. Okay, so that is an example of initialization. The next, string my name semicolon, string my address semicolon. Ito naman po, guys, is example ng declaration. Okay, so yung dalawang code na nakalagay sa baba, the last two code, can also be written in string my name comma my address semicolon. So pwede lang din yan, guys, na paraan. Bakit pwede? Because we are stating na si my name and my address, meron silang iisang data type, which is string data type. Okay? So, next po natin, yung tamang paraan kung paano gumawa ng variable name. Okay? So, these are the things you need to remember. Okay, a variable name must be unique. So, pag sinabi nating unique, guys, dapat wala siyang kapareho. Katulad ng puto nung student ID or yung employee's ID mo, wala kang kapareho nung ID. An example, we have int num1, comma, num2, comma, num3, semicolon. Okay, so meron tayong tatlong variable. And kung titignan nyo, magkakaiba po sila ng variable name. Hindi po sila magkakapareho. The next, all variable names should begin with a letter. It's either capital letter or small letter or an underscore. Okay? So, an example, we have int num1, small letter n, pwede lang. We have num2, capital N, pwede lang din. We have underscore num3, okay? So, pwede lang din yung underscore. So, kung titignan natin, guys, nakalagay dyan, begin with a letter or underscore. Letter and underscore lang po yung pwede. Hindi po nakalagay na begin with a number. So, kapag naglagay po tayo ng int, then number 1, hindi po siya pwede. Okay? So, always start with a letter or underscore. Don't start with numbers. The next, space is not allowed when declaring a variable. Example, string my name equals to ITS, semicolon. So, kung titignan natin, guys, my name, meron siyang space sa gitna. So, this is an example of invalid variable. Hindi po siya pwede. Magkaka-error po kayo dyan. Bakit? Kasi meron siyang space. So, para maayos po yun, pwede yung ganitong paraan. String, my name, okay, sa gitna ng my and name, meron siyang underscore. Or, string, my name. Capital letter mo yung first letter nung next na word. Pwede lang. Okay? So, don't forget, don't use space. Another. Spaces and special characters except underscore are not allowed. So, sabi nga, bawal ang space. Ano naman yung mga special character na hindi allowed? Ito po yung mga yon. Okay? These are not allowed. Next, a keyword cannot be used as variable name. Example of keywords, we have main, public, private, console, write, read. Okay? So, yun yung mga words na nakikita natin default dun sa C# program natin. Hindi pwede natin gamitin yun. Most importantly, variables are case sensitive. So, paano natin sinabing case sensitive? First, let's say meron kang string name. Semicolon, nag-declare ka ng string name. The next, console.write parenthesis, capital N, name. See? Yung small letter na N na name versus yung capital letter N na name are not the same. Bakit hindi pa sila magkapareho? Because C# is case sensitive. Okay? So, kapag nakapital mo yung isang letter, kahit isang letter lang, guys, hindi na po sila magkapareho. Unique na po silang dalawa. Okay? Now, let's go with the data type. Defines the type of data a programming element should be assigned. This tells the compiler which type of data is used for processing. Okay, so yung data type, guys, ito po yung nagsasabi na ito lang yung pwede mong i-hold. So, sasabihin niya dun sa variable natin na. Okay, so, ito lang yung pwede mong i-hold, yung iba, hindi na pwede. That is the work of the data type. These are the commonly used data type. We have void, bool, byte, char, int, float or double, and string. So guys, discuss po natin yung pinaka-common natin ginagamit dun sa data types. Okay, number one, we have bool. One of the simplest data type. It can contain only two values. Yun lang po yung true or false. Important to understand when using logical operators and conditional statements. For logical operators and conditional statements, madi-discuss po yan later on dun sa mga next videos. Example, we have bool I can equals true semicolon. Okay? So, kung papansinin natin, true lang yung value niya. Okay? Because bool can only contain true or false. Yun lang ang kailangan nyong alalahanin kapag gagamitin nyo yung data type na bool. Dapat true or false lang yung sagot or yung value niya. The next, we have int. Short for integer, a data type for storing whole numbers. When working with numbers, int is the most commonly used data type. Example, int num equals 0. Okay? So, kapag gagamitin naman natin, guys, ang int, ang alalahanin lang natin dyan, guys, is for whole numbers. Next, string. Used for storing text or letters. It uses double quotes. Example, string my name equals to ITS. So, kapag gagamitin naman natin yung string that is for text or letters. Okay? Then, dapat always gagamitan niya ng double quote. Another, we have char. Used for storing a single Unicode character. Example, char middle name equals C. Okay, so ginagamit naman po yan for single character. So, kapag gamitin naman natin yan, guys, dapat meron kang single quote. The next, guys, we have the float and double. One of the data type used for storing numbers which may contain decimals. Example, double num equals 93.3 and so on. That is for double. Yung float naman, okay, float num equals 89.3f, semicolon. Okay, so kung titignan natin ang difference ng float and double, yung double, walang f. Yung float, merong f. Yun lang. The next, ginagamit yung float kapag meron kang limit ng memory. Pero pinaka-common na ginagamit ngayon is the double. Kasi nga, yung mga technologies naman na ngayon, hindi naman na nagli-limit ng memory. So, ang dapat lang natin intindihin kapag ginagamit natin yung float or double is decimal numbers. Okay? So, float or double, merong decimal. The next, when inputting a value. Kapag po tayo nag-i-input ng value, alalahanin po natin na every input natin kay C#, kino-consider po niya yun na string. So, lahat ng ine-enter natin kay C#, that is considered to be string data type. So, paano natin siya gawin na integer, double, bool, and other data types? Gagamit po tayo ng method. Okay? So, this method will be discussed sa next na video. Yung paano natin i-convert into sa specific data type niya. Okay? So, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more updated videos. Bye!